So plant meristem cells is going to be the last type of stem cell video that I'm going to create. And these plant meristem cells, they are found in regions of shoots and roots of plants. Okay, so that is where they are located. Okay, and if we're thinking about what can they differentiate into, they can differentiate into all cell types. Okay, and these can be used to create clones of whole plants. So, if you were, for example, you had this certain plant that you wanted to create an exact copy of, you could do it via the process of using plant meristem cells. Okay, so if we're thinking about that, that's going to form a massive advantage for the use of plant meristem cells, okay? So we can use that process of clones to prevent sort of rare species of plant, okay, from dying out. So that can be a really good process of making sure we can prevent extinction of that type of plant, okay? And then, if we're thinking about it, we can have plants with desirable traits, okay? So we can use this process to basically hold and transfer these desirable traits. And some of these might be disease resistance, or they can be helping to create large numbers of identical plants. So that can really help to in like crop output. And if we're thinking about that, we can have a fast and low cost production of large numbers of plants, okay? So then that can be used as a process in terms of creating large numbers of crops, for example, okay? But as we always have, as I've said on the last ones, where there will be a disadvantage involved in this. And for plant meristem cells, is that if everything is identical, then there is going to be a risk with that, okay? And then they could all be basically wiped out or destroyed by a single disease or genetic defect. So let's say, for example, if they caught a certain type of disease, okay, and if one of them got it and died, then that means that every single one of those plants is going to die from that disease because they all have exactly the same DNA. They are clones of each other from this process. Okay, and that just brings a summary, an end to the summaries of the three different types of stem cell. If you follow the instructions for the rest of the slide, I will look forward to seeing your work.